Good morning. I'm John Hudson, pastor of the Pilgrim United Church of Christ in Sherbourne, Massachusetts, and the writer of Spiritually Speaking, a weekly newspaper column for Gannett Media. And I welcome you to another of my weekly video essays with thoughts about how all of us can lean into and get through these strange and amazing days. So, a confession. I am a full-blown news junkie. A news junkie. I have been since the days long ago when I delivered the morning newspaper to all of my customers, newspaper like this one. After the end of that paper route, I'd always sit in the driveway of my boyhood home and read the newspaper, catch up on the news from the first page to the last. And though the way we humans get the news and consume the news nowadays, there are no more paper boys or paper girls anymore. Still, the hope is the same, that as citizens, it is our right and our responsibility to be current with current events, to know and be in the know about the state of our communities and nation and world, to educate ourselves so we can be good neighbors, informed voters, active community folk. But what has changed when it comes to the news? Well, there's so much more of the news, right? So many more outlets and TV shows and magazines and newspapers and Facebook posts and Twitter and, well, you get the picture. I know if I am not careful and wise about how I get the news and where I get the news, I can get confused. I wonder about what is really true, and what is really false. Who can I trust to tell me the truth? Who is not so much telling the news as giving their spin on the news? Where should I go to find out what is going on? You know, in the scriptures, a man named Pontius Pilate once asked Jesus, "What is truth? What is truth? Quid est veritas?" And us, in these COVID days, with an election coming up, with so much at stake, with COVID, with struggles around racial justice, friends, I think all of us need to ask that same question as people of faith and as citizens. What is truth? What is truth? Who can be trusted to tell us the truth? And most important, perhaps, is where can I find reliable information? As both a pastor and a working journalist, here's some advice. First, be very careful about where you get the news and pay close attention to where it comes from. Is it a random article on Facebook or Twitter? Is it an article that you can't find confirmation for anywhere else? If so, you may want to think twice about that news article. Be wise. Is this source dependable? And read both sides of the story. I know I now read both newspapers and sources considered liberal and papers and sources considered conservative. You see, you can't get the whole story unless you get the whole story. And if a piece of news sounds outrageous or unbelievable or suspect or crazy, it probably is. So dig deeper. Ask people you trust what they think, especially when it comes to really important news, like news about COVID, or news about a vaccine, or news about public health. I believe we should always trust the experts and the scientists, first and foremost. As the scientist Neil deGrasse Tyson once said, the good thing about science is that it is true, whether or not you believe it. And finally, I'd advise all of us to not get buried under too much news. Be informed, but know when to put down the smartphone and to close the laptop and to turn off the TV and to recycle the newspaper. There is truth in the printed word, in the spoken word, and there is truth in just being alive and in enjoying this life. And so, friends, that is my news for the day. Thanks for joining me. Our church offers worship every Sunday morning on this Facebook page at 9:50 a.m., and we invite you to join us. Take good care, and I pray that you and yours and your loved ones and all of us, that we can keep the faith. Be well, stay safe, and God bless all of us, and God bless our world. Thank you.